Hold on a second.
We have heard so many people.
Sorry.
And one thing is, you are killing your strength. You are no longer you, but Christ.
Selfish or self, no, self-centered. Everything
that happens. What actually is stopping you?
I don't do what I don't want to do. That's what I do.
Paul says in 1:4,
okay, wretched man I am, who can deliver me from the body of death? But what the 5th verse says, thank God for Jesus Christ. There were millions of people who were on the middle cross because Jesus embraced everybody in order to kill.
The manuscript of prophecy says that it wasn't because
the reason why we came here was actually to learn something, to worship Him in spirit and truth. So whatever you have learned today, if it is not leading you to testify, then please pray that happens in your life.
Saying when there was a struggle.
The third day they keep his testimony and seek him the Lord's heart. Just be learning which is the work in his ways. That's the master key they
reading from New King James Version.
First Corinthians chapter 14, verse 8, goes like this.
For if the trumpet makes an uncertain sound, who will prepare for battle? May the Lord bless us as we continue to worship, take a journey through this scripture.
And so there was another flight that we came in the presence of the Lord where whenever we meet in his name, he encourages us that joining this camp in Malta, this contact, Sudesh Narayan, who is John, working is not here at the moment. I think the last day is the 15th of November. And so you need to get in touch with him. There is a deposit, so you need to contact Sudesh regarding this. And our next year's next day of fellowship is the 15th of September. So we have a year's warning. And sometimes people say, when I didn't know the date, we usually set the date at the previous meeting. So we are setting the date then for the next year's meeting, that is 15th of September 2018. So you want to put that into your diary. Thank you very much.
We are here, dear Lord, to worship you and to honor you. We thank you for all the
and happy Sabbath, children. Tell you a very good story that comes from the Bible. Because when you disobey, then things which you are not supposed to do, when you do, your parents. So she got a very beautiful teddy bear. She loved it so much. Wherever she went, she took used to take the teddy bear with her when she went. She did what she is not supposed to do. Did mommy say not to bring to church? Yes. So like Jesus threw the things that you won't bring any toys to the church from next Sabbath.
Yeah.
point, we want to look at Jeremiah chapter 48, from verse 1 to Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 4. Recently, I was in Jerusalem, or rather in Israel, and I had taken a large group, and quite a few of them were young people. One of the things that struck me during my time there, especially with our youngsters, who are the second and third generation Adventists in this country, is the lack of biblical knowledge. And these are young people that have grown up in Adventist schools, and some of them have gone to Adventist schools. But unfortunately, quite a few of them didn't even know some of the stories that we grew up hearing.
When I was going through a drought, there was a famine. There was no water. There was a famine happening. And the people were in great distress, had 10 tribes, and the southern kingdom, which came to be called Judah, had just 2 tribes, Judah and Benjamin. And they had Jerusalem as their capital, while the northern kingdom had simply now to wander. What the Lord is talking about is that the people wandered away from God to other gods. It's like we sometimes get together, maybe a Saturday evening, that's the only time we can spare for God. You have to remember your wickedness and destroy you. You know, God has not warned anyone to perish. And parents sit in their inner rooms and cry and weep. And our God is like that. Our God's heart aches and pains when His children walk away from Him. And so, this is what the Lord says, verse 17, let my eyes overflow with tears. We would like to read those blessed passages, and we forget where the Lord has led us in the past. I mean, whether we came from which part of India. I mean, the history of God's people. God called a people. God called Abraham and brought him into the land that He promised. And you know all the experience of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and Ishmael and the 12 tribes crossing over Jordan, coming into the promised land and going up the Canaanites and not doing exactly what God wanted them to do, and then in fighting among themselves. Therefore, they were all different tribes, 12 tribes. They were willing to work together and jam together. Sometimes it's like us today. To tell the fact, sometimes we call ourselves Malayalis and Telugus and Tamils and North Indians, South Indians, and we have a problem in ourselves, isn't that? That's a fact, whether we like to hear it or not. And even after leaving our country and coming here, sometimes we do the same thing. And so, you know, and we don't live forever on this land. There's a time limit. There's a time limit on us. We hold this so many years, no matter how much ginger or garlic you eat, doesn't make any difference. All that is good, don't eat your cheese and be vegetarians and eat soy or drink soy milk and eat peanut butter. You can do all that. All that will help to live well, possibly, for a while. But the time comes. You know, I was sitting in a meeting in one of my churches. It was an evening program. It was a health program. And so, you know, if it's a Bible study in the afternoon, we don't get up. But if somebody comes to talk to us about physical health, it seems that we are all there, almost, in large numbers. And this chap came, he was from one of the Caribbean islands, And he stood up and he talked about a bush and which would heal all your diseases. Almost to give you a last life. And so he was talking, he kept saying this word, Moringa, Moringa. And I went, what is this Moringa? And so I was trying to Google this, sitting there in church, and so on. Eventually, I discovered what it was. And in my language, there is, it is pronounced slightly differently. And, you know, in my own language, it is Murinyeka. And I said to myself, I grew up eating this day in and day in, day in and day out. I remember a tree of, you know, drum sticks, that's the English word for it, isn't it? We didn't want to just throw it out, so we would make this into a curry, and then we would scrape out the inside and put some grated coconut, make a nice dish, and we would, and then cut them in half and put some pepper and sort of fry it. And you know, you just use your imagination and see what you can do with it. Now, I said to myself, listen, I grew up with this, eating it. And I said to myself, you know, my grandfather died. My grandmother died. My uncles all died. And they have been eating this moringa. For starvation to starvation. Those for captivity to captivity. And so here we have a God who seems to be very hard God. All kinds of destroyers against them, declares the Lord. The sword will kill, the dogs to drag away, and the birds and the wild animals to devour. That we can do that even God cannot forgive and forget. You know, there are things, I mean, we can think of something that to us when we were children, when we were growing up, or something who should have known better and should have come to our help when we need. All of us can think of those. Even God had one. Manasseh. And so he says, I will make them abhorrent to all the kingdoms of the earth because of what Manasseh, son of Hezekiah. Hezekiah was a good king. Just because you are a good parent doesn't mean that you have good children. Hezekiah was a good king.